I'm really happy for him. His five-game stretch here, even his numbers aren't the greatest, but they're really good, but it's just been his leadership and getting the guys to play as a team. I think he's done as well leadership-wise as Eugene or any of the guys we've had here. And that's saying a lot. We've had some really good leaders, going back to E.J. Singler and Dylan Brooks, guys, Joe Young, that just took the team and kept everybody together and just did a tremendous job. And this five-game stretch by Will has been as good as anybody's ever done in my tenure here, and I'm just really happy for him. I'm happy that he put a game like that together.
I think his assists are a career high as well for him tonight. He's done it all for the last, like you said, five games, but just what's made him so good at it?
Well, we've got the ball in his hands a lot, and we're putting a lot of pressure on him to make plays. And teams are coming after him, pretty hard. Tell a few times when he drove, how quickly they collapsed and really tried to go after him. So he's getting some opportunities to make plays. But I just think, he's done a tremendous job making decisions and getting the right people the ball and, encouraging guys when they don't finish a play. That's part of that leadership that I think he's done a tremendous job with.
Danny, when you have a guy who's 10.5 minutes away from the triple double, just needs one rebound, as a coach, I know you can't game plan rebounds, but are you talking to guys and saying, hey?
I didn't even know it. I didn't know he was going. He hit the three. I was going to take mine. He goes, no, coach, I want to finish the game. And I said, all right. You're running the show anyway. Go ahead, but I didn't know that he needed one rebound to get it.
So did you find out?
When everybody started cheering, I figured, I'd kind of turn around, and so I didn't know until then.
You said he needed to get better at rebounds, and obviously he did today. But has that been a focal point for him? Is that like one area?
Well, it's a focal point for everyone. I mean, we lost it. UCLA, and there were a number of reasons, but the biggest reason, we got out-rebounded. We can't, play big or even play small and get out-rebounded that bad. We out-rebounded them by 8. We held them to 33%. With 5 minutes to go in the game, I think we had 7 turnovers. 7 or 8 turnovers. You do those 3 things, you're going to win a lot of basketball games. And regardless of how you shoot, we hit some threes finally tonight. Quincy got us off to a great start. And, the guys needed to see the ball go through the basket, 28%. We needed something good there. But, I don't know. I'm just happy that we out-rebounded somebody. I'm happy that defensively, for the most part, we were pretty locked in. We made some bad mistakes there when they had their run, with that last 5 minutes of the first half. We made some really bad defensive mistakes. Guys just weren't locked in, and so I was glad to see us do a little bit better the second half.
You play as much as Will does, it's kind of get some of these numbers just kind of organically, but with the assist particularly made in the last 5 games, guys have to finish it, and you have to shoot better. So is it that Quincy moving back more to the floor at times, particularly today, that helps? Is it just general offensive, Dante, is it Brendan coming back, all of the above?
All of the above. Brendan gives us another guy who can at least, handle the ball a little bit. Quincy seems to be a little more comfortable, at the 4 spot. I think it's a combination of things. Keeping Dante on the floor is important. Need to get him the ball, and so that's going to be important. So I think there are a number of factors, but he's got to continue to move the ball and continue to get a feel when they're collapsing on him to get it out of his hands a little quicker. But he's really playing well. And until we get Key back, until we get Jermaine back, he's going some physicality with your defense. You know, Eugene was the best we've had, but Paul would take him. You know, Waldo's taken some charges. You know, we've got to get some other guys to think about that. Now, you know, block shot, we blocked 11 shots tonight. You know, so Khalil did a good job there with four. I think Dante had three. So if we can get those two guys blocking seven shots tonight, you know. But I think some of our guards, you know, probably other than Will, I just don't need him taking a chance picking up a foul. But, you know, the other guys, you know, we need to get a little bit more aggressive trying to take some charges.
This has been the most minutes Luke Ward's played over like a five-game stretch. What have you just seen from him? It feels like every game he maybe shows just a little bit more of improvement these last couple of weeks.
He's done some good things, you know, especially rebounding the ball. He had six rebounds at UCLA. He had seven tonight. It's got to be his main focus. The one he missed, you know, cost us a three-pointer. But, you know, he's got to focus in on what he can give us. And, you know, he was hunting those threes tonight. He had some pretty good looks. But he's been shooting well in practice, so had no problem with the shots. But getting seven rebounds helps us, four on the offensive end, and keeps us going.